Right, when signalling allows, which it does. DRA is on. Shed height. How was Trainspotting at the weekend, RS Gaming? It's brilliant. The video's up on YouTube. It's like an hour and it was tons of trains and there was a 37 at the end of it, so... Successful train spotting, very successful. Yeah, Cameron went with me. Cameron was the one who really wanted to go. Hell's Bells, can I explain the cup on the right-hand side of the screen? So it's for Twitch Cheers. If you Google Twitch Cheers, you can find out what they are. It's essentially a donation mechanism. But what happens is that they... when someone does a Twitch donation via Twitch cheering, then the bits get dumped into the glass. And it just makes it a little bit more fun because bigger donations... are bigger and heavier, so they tend to splash out the smaller ones. Double yellow, that's where I want to be. I thought you were seeing things. Rob Powell! Start work on that tomorrow, Matt. Just assume I'm going to play the scenarios on stream. How do you mean, Rob? Call it for the red light coming up. Red light. When we were doing a Eurofishing match, We might do some Euro fishing tomorrow after Sim Airport, actually. We'll see whether people want to do fishing on Friday as well. Been busy working with the Royal Scotsman. Nice, hell's bells. Never need to apologise. Come here when you can. Got double yellow. Yeah, I need to get OpenTTD downloaded at some point, Ed. We've got a 15 limit coming up now. So we left Barking just behind us and we're on our way to Camden Road, one stop. You found Norton hates SimSig. I'll be honest, I've found actually antivirus software normally causes more trouble than the viruses do. On an ongoing, day-to-day basis, I think you lose more productivity from your computer having the software in than you would having to rebuild it every now and again. As strange as that sounds, and in no way just says, am I suggesting you should take off your antivirus software, but still, that's always been my feeling. Get some speed increases soon. When was the last time I ran a class 33? Quite a while ago, actually. Wow. Yep, take an image. Nice one, Ryan. Is Macrium another commercial one, like the old Ghost, or is it a, is that a freeware one? I've not heard of Macrium before. Good night, Andrew. Rygar, TS World or TS 17? Well, I'm the senior producer for TS World, so colour me biased. TS 17's got a lot more breadth and it's been around a lot longer. Rob, never looked at the logistics of releasing scenario packs for myself on my own site or third party, so it's a new challenge for me to look at going solo, especially when it comes to pricing. We'll get there in the end. Oh, right, yes, sorry, I see what you were saying before. Just thinking it might be a way for you to get the ball rolling on your own so that you can be independent, and then if, as and when other things move along, you can decide what you want to do, rather than being always waiting, you can sort of take a step forward on your own, if you like. Thank you for the tip there, Rob, as well. Really appreciate that. GG's for Rob. Sorry, Rygar, did I answer your question? Yeah, TS17's got lots of variety in it, but it's an older engine. TS World really has the one route and three locos. But is a much, much newer game engine, so it's kind of, really, you can have a look and see what they are. Look at all my videos, I've got loads of videos on both, and you can decide what sort of fits your, what you're looking to do. Actually, thinking about it, Ryan, you might want to have a chat with Rob. Rob has skills that might be useful to you. I'll leave that to you to discover what they are. Rygar, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Thrash it. I'd love to thrash it. I'd love to thrash it, but we're doing 16 and a 20, so. Single yellow. Hey, Reptile Rick, how are you? How have you been getting on today? I saw you streaming earlier on. Ooh, 50 limit. I wonder if that means that they're going to start opening up with some green lights. Yay! Someone say thrash. Double yellow. Ryus Gaming, can I explain what you do to Rob rather than me type it? So Ryan works with one of the rail training organisations who's looking after, amongst other things, the Crossrail training, and they use Train Simulator as part of that. So they use GEML and all sorts of things. So Ryan looks after the tech side of it, does a lot of content creation to go with it, scenario creation, all that kind of stuff. Really, you know, right up your wheelhouse, I think, Rob. This is, as in, if you didn't get that, I mean, professional driver training for real drivers on the Crossrail, on the Elizabeth line. Reptile Rick, this is a Class 37. This is a relatively old train in the UK. This one is still a running one. Should be a friendly signal. GG signal visibility though. Yellow. Mattia B77, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Good night, Hellsbells. You got a busy day on the Scotsman. Try and be around for the next stream. Awesome. Yeah, I'm looking forward to catching up with you, Ryan, next time when we meet up, because I'm really out of touch with what you guys are doing these days. DLC Rail fan, you went to workshop, subscribed to Chris Meskin's scenario. Yeah, I always drive it from. So what you should go into the standard tab, and just type HOLZL in the search field, and it'll come up, and you can run it there. Because running it through the main scenario list, it ignores any checks for whether or not you own anything. It just lets you get on and do it. This is Stratford. Looks like we've got a green light. Yep. Yeah, it's a standard DLC rail fan. Most workshop scenarios, to be honest, are standard. Not all, but most. So where are we? Where we started? This is the merged route, I think, with the North London line. So we started at Barking, which is there. Yeah, I think we started there, and then we've worked our way up, crossed over to Woodgrange, worked our way down to Stratford, and now we're running our way across here up onto the North London line until we get to here. No, you don't need any reskins, SDH. I don't run scenarios that need reskins. Yeah, the Goblin line has a link to the Great Eastern Main line. Dan Demand, that's for the big simulator, isn't it? For the multi-million pound one, I think. I think I saw that article. Alright, speed's dropping down to 25. Coming through... God, I can't remember the name of it now. Hackney Wick, that's what I meant. That's the one we're going on, is it, Ryan?
Yes.
Put on a show through the stations, haven't you? This thing's tilting like it's an aircraft. You're not an aircraft train, you're a train. Steam Challenge Unlimited. I must admit I don't know anything about it. I've not looked at the JT Clan class and how it's going on to Steam, so I've no idea whether or not it's compatible with the other one. Dave, Somerset Freight Train derailment causes 48-hour blockage. Have I been up in Somerset again? Not that anyone's officially acknowledging, no. Still following greens. 4.6 now to Camden. No, I didn't give the rest of the keys away yet, Ryan. I was going to do that a little bit later on this week. Rob, have you looked at DPS Northeast, the DPSimulations Northeast on Workshop? It's quite a lot nicer than the default route. It might be worth considering using that, perhaps. Have a look, RS Gaming. I don't know if anyone's done an electrified West Coast mainline. That's for the drop to 35. Discord are experiencing outages due to issues with Google Cloud. Yeah, they're getting there. You'd like to see Festinio Railway come? Oh yeah, you and me. You and my both steam trains unlimited. Ooh, shed hype! Shouldn't there be a TSR through there? On the main. Yeah, I've been on the Festinio Railway, it's beautiful. King Bond! Hey Matt, thank you very much for the cheer, King Bond. Welcome. Yeah, we did a bit of TS World earlier on, and now we're doing sort of three sessions now on TS. So this is number two. And we've got a rail fanning session coming up after this. Welsh Highland route is nice too. Well, really, what you want to do is you'd want to do the joined up Festiniog and Welsh Highland, wouldn't you? Because they're all joined up now, if I remember rightly. One and a half miles to go. Yeah, joined through the street at Port Maddock. That's what I thought. Because when I went down there, they hadn't actually done the last bit to join them up yet. Yeah, I've been on the Festiniog. I haven't been on the Welsh Highland or the Talaclyn. Talaclyn would be nice to ride. Why is the 101 not got a destination board for Darlington? I don't know. Are you looking at the 101 that came with Weird Al? Because that does. I think. Hey, Al Wilson, trucker boy. Of course, if we're down there, Ed, you'd want to do the Lake Line, and you'd want to do Snowdon Mountain Railway as well. Al Wilson, trucker boy, thank you for the follow, sir. Much appreciated. That sounds interesting, GWR. Long time since you dabbled in train sim. Expensive and a bit dull. I must admit, I've not been up there, so. No, the brakes aren't on King Bond. They're in their holding state. They're, because below that you've got the quick release state. Not at all, Francois. Not at all. Right, double yellow. 3/4 of a mile to go there or thereabouts. We transfer onto the West Coast Mainline and park in the sidings and stop. No, we're not going to the West Coast Mainline. We're only going as far as Camden, which is here. West Coast Mainline would be this area. Normally you do the interchange at Willesden over here. Someone at your university asked if you want to be part of a cat appreciation society. It's a fantastic route, Stephen Jam. It really is. It's sort of got a networky feel to it. And there is actually the link up with the South London network as well for even more possibilities. And also the link up with Chatham Mainline. Is Heathrow involved in the Goblin Line? No. No, there's no airports involved in the Goblin Line. Right, rolling into Camden now. brakes are a bit sharp on this. Andy, I think it'll work on there. I don't know how well it'll work. It should work reasonably well. You might need to turn some settings down potentially, but 940 is not isn't bad for a laptop. I've seen people running it on a 920. So it could be a lot worse. As long as it's not an Intel embedded graphics adapter, because they're fatal for great for gaming. Well done, driver. Right, that's all the driving. Oh, now I get to sit back and watch trains. With you, we all get to sit and watch trains. Oh, sorry, my neck. Problem with the track IR is that sort of holding my head still so that the view doesn't move around and give myself a sore neck. Right, now, let me just check the situation on memory. I am going to restart the game. Hold on a minute, folks. Oh, dear, oh, dear.